Hey, what's up everybody? This is Frank with Frankly Collecting, and today we are gonna check out my MetaZoo Kickstarter playing cards Headcaster tier. So this should have 75 decks inside. I don't remember how many artist prints, if more, or if I got more than those, but that should be randomized. We're gonna see which one of those I got. We're gonna see the Headcaster promo card. Now you can see over here, I did get my uncut sheets in, and I'm not gonna actually open these on camera. I think there's gonna be a lot of videos showing these. And I just kind of, if I'm going to frame these, I want to take them direct to the frame shop and just kind of take them right out of the tube and get them straight in the framing queue. So I don't really kind of want to risk handling them by showing them off in the video. But I did get those for any of those wondering. I saw TCG Collector had an issue where I think he hadn't received his uncut sheets yet, but these came all at once for me. So without further ado, let's open up this main package and see what's inside. All right, so let's check out the artist print first thing. Here we go. We've got Mike Peckham, the Few Foil, Few Follett. Okay, very cool. Yeah, this looks really nice. No bent corners. I saw a TCG Collector, look him up. He did a video of his opening and he got several prints and one of them had a ding corner, which is unfortunate. And some of them were missing the security seals, but I have that here. No issues, really great print. Very happy with this one. Let's see, number 7 out of 35. Few Follett, very cool. Just in time for Halloween, kind of a spooky cryptid. Very happy with this print. It's a little bit impromptu, but we're gonna try our best here. I don't wanna crush any of these promos, but here you go. So really cool. So you've got tons of decks here, all lined up, and then just like stacks of promos on the top here. And I'm guessing that the, Headcaster promo is going to be among these, or maybe kind of buried underneath of them. We're going to find out together. Okay, there's all of the regular promos. We got Cryptonation, Nightfall, and Wilderness. I got a few more in here. Okay, so as of the making of this video, I don't know what I'm going to do with all these promos yet. I guess I have so many extra that at some point I'm going to maybe sell them, but honestly, maybe I'll just get a binder and just sleeve them and have a binder full of promos. Okay. Wow, this came out so nice. So check that out. Headcaster promo, number 105, accounted for out of 250. Really curious to see how these are gonna do on the secondary market. I see one on eBay right now for listed under $1,000. And yeah, I just think it's really cool. I'm not gonna be selling mine. I actually wanna send mine off to PSA and just, it's gonna be kind of like a grail item in my collection. I think these are just so cool, and the poker cards, these playing cards, are going to be so distinctive from other MetaZoo products. I just think that this one's going to stand out over the long term and not really kind of be cannibalized as much by other promo cards. Now, something that I really like, I'll show it outside of the top loader here, is that these came in holofoil, and maybe there was an update during the Kickstarter sharing that these were going to be in foil, because I remember when the Kickstarter campaign was going on, I don't think it specified that these would be foil. And I assumed actually from the pictures that they would not be. And I was kind of a little bit bummed by that. And then when I saw pictures of it at some point, I was like, oh my gosh, they did make these holofoil. So I'm so glad they did. It was, you know, it made sense for these sort of chase promos. Oh man, these are really nice. So the foils on these, I don't know if you can tell in this video, but they're like, they have all these stars going through them. They look really nice. Very distinctive. So really happy with this one, and doesn't look like any whitening at all on it. Centering looks okay, a little bit off center, I think top to bottom, but I'm gonna be sending this off. You know, probably gonna get at least a 9. It'd be awesome to get a 10 on this. And yeah, I'll show that on my video or Instagram or something once that comes back. Really happy with that. It came with this red ink coin as well. It says MetaZoo Bounty. So I don't know what's going on with this. I didn't get the poker chips as an add-on. I guess everybody gets this red ink bounty poker chip. Very cool. Actually, I don't even know how to play poker, so I don't know if bounty means something specific, but that's pretty neat. I know PSA grades like Pokemon coins, so maybe they would grade this as well as the other poker chips. Don't know anything about that. All right, I'm gonna lay all these out real quick for you now and make a cut so you can just kind of see all of these 75 decks at once. Okay, here it is. So we've got 75 playing decks, 25 Cryptonation, 25 Nightfall, 25 Wilderness, and then I guess 10 of these promo boxes. Now these did come out really nice. So very classic, kind of clean, minimalist design here. Here's one for the Cryptid Nation. I like how they say magic is real on the back. That's really cool. And they have their own sort of emblem with the set name. So here's Nightfall. And then finally, here is Wilderness. Okay, so I am not exactly sure what I'm gonna be doing with all of this stuff. This print, I would like to frame, and I'm definitely gonna be grading my Headcaster promo. I'll probably sleeve up and binder these promos. And then honestly, for the time being, I'm probably just gonna throw these back in the box and just sit on them for a while. Maybe every now and then I'll open one for fun or just kind of follow in the secondary market. Honestly, I haven't decided yet. You know, I wanted that really tough promo card. I wanted to have my MetaZoo Grow item. And these promos are cool, but just for the time being, I'm just gonna be putting these away for now and seeing what they do over the short and also the long term. I think they're just really cool. I'm glad to have 75 of these. This is, you know, I don't really invest in sealed product, not a lot of it. So this can just kind of be like my big sealed thing that I'm sitting on. Now, my price prediction for these, I noticed on the secondary market, these regular decks sealed are going for between $5 and $10. I would guess sort of if the stars are all aligned in MetaZoo's favor that these could get up to maybe $10 or $20 this year. That's just my pure speculation, my pure guess. And the reason being is I think a lot of people, you know, if you're going for a specific foil card of a cryptid you like maybe the Mothman or the Red Ink or something, I think people are going to be willing to pay a premium and just pick up that one card off the secondary market and be done with it. I'm not sure that a lot of people are going to be wanting to buy up a ton of these decks just to open and search for the right card and then have to deal with like what the remaining cards, which will become bulk for that person. I feel like people are going to be willing to pay a premium. I mean, obviously depending on what that premium is and what people are willing to sell that card for, just to get the one that they want and save all the time of hassle of multiple orders of buying lots of these and going through and opening them up and having the chance of not getting the card you want and that kind of thing. I think these are gonna be a product that can stand out against all the other promos and products that MetaZoo is doing. You know, the fact that they are playing cards, you know, MetaZoo has this problem of having so many products that they can tend to compete with one another. But the playing cards are distinct enough, I think, that they will be able to stand out even amongst more and more products coming out for MetaZoo. So I do think there's going to be a premium that will stay with the playing decks. And this is all, you know, assuming that MetaZoo continues to be successful and grow its audience and continues to be an IP going forward. But I'm also, what's making me sort of not be too aggressive with my price prediction of around $10 to $20 is the simple fact that the macroeconomic environment that we are in right now is not great. You know, other world events and things like that. You know, I think at least for the rest of the year, if there's movement in this product, maybe it gets up to $10 to $20 per deck. I don't know. That's again, just my, if I had to guess, that's what I'm gonna go with. And then maybe in the long term, you know, more than that. But we're just gonna have to see. You know, there's just so much uncertainty in the air right now. All right, thanks for joining me and seeing my opening, seeing everything I got. And let me know down in the comments below if you agree or disagree with my particular price prediction and why. And also just what do you think about the product? Do you think they delivered on this Kickstarter? Personally, I'd love to see them do a third Kickstarter and something else new and distinctive for MetaZoo. All right, thanks so much for watching. Consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.